I've been meaning to do this this video for some time, and don't know why I haven't come around to it. But those of you, the few of you that have been keeping up with the videos, I'm doing quite a number, a few every week, maybe even every day. And my last video was about supporting the most important person that is fighting to get rid of nuclear anything, Kevin Blanch down in Utah. And I want to tell you what I've learned for myself. And when I say learned, I mean it in an experiential way. It's not something that I read in a book. It's something I try out for myself. When I make a painting, I try things out. I work at what I learn experientially and where it leads me. And of course, it's not a linear process in the sense that you learn how to pick up a hammer and nail into a 2x4. It's not that way. Learning is something that has to do with discovery, something that comes out of oneself, out of myself. Learning is the essence of our becoming. As I understand it, there is no point in living on this planet without even having once had your own breakthrough. Like I've said, children who tie their shoelaces, to us it's commonplace, but they have an epiphany and a breakthrough that through some manipulation of this string on their shoe, they can actually tie it in a way that keeps their shoe on their foot. This is a breakthrough moment for children. And I think this process needs to be encouraged in children. We need to understand that learning is part of our becoming, part of a process that's essential for us to survive. And now, of course, here comes the crucial word. I bring up the word survive. And I'm going to make this comment on all the YouTubers, people outside of YouTube, writing books, making paintings, writing news reports, making any kind of statement that is the intention of which is to help us become, to learn, to deliver us to ourselves. This is what I think, in essence, my teachers were able to teach me when I went to art school. They were, at their best, delivering me to myself. They told me of techniques, ways of applying materials, ways of looking, concentrating, focusing, a form of meditation. I was being taught a form of meditation, sitting for days and weeks in front of a model, painting that model, drawing that model. They had a concept of learning through delivering me to myself. This is the greatest part of their teaching. And what I believe learning is to take what is around you and interpret, translate it through yourself, through myself. And what comes out at the other end? In this case, it's a rather oblique reference to another artist in history, which is magnificent. Michelangelo, completely warped, twisted in our minds. Michelangelo no longer has the power because he's been twisted. He's not been twisted for me, but he has been twisted. People have not learned, have not been delivered to themselves, and this is my brief, direct comment about people who are attempting to elucidate my vision of the world, what I understand the world to mean, the absolute depth and feeling I try to have connected to that which is around me. People aid me, help me. And I have to tell you, there are very few people left now. I can listen to very few people anymore. I actually don't listen to very many people anymore. And the reason I don't listen is because they're not dealing, they're not exposing, they're not elucidating that which will deliver me to myself. And as such, I become a vehicle for other people to be delivered. That is what art is. Art, when you look at art, when you look at a great painting, you are delivered. You are being influenced on the deepest, most profound level. And anyone that does not bring up the most crucial, important, life-changing to the point of extinction changing, extinction level event occurring. On our watch, we are all responsible. We are those people. If you imagine yourself during the Nazi era, people were being herded into concentration camps, and you lived in a house on a street, and you had your shutters open, and as they walked the prisoners to their deaths, you closed your shutters. This is the equivalency that I will invoke on Fukushima. You are now closing your shutters unless you, in every moment, in some way or other, you are aware of the severity and significance of this event. I have said, I've talked about the Pacific, I've talked about this, a nation, a brilliant nation, that has brought forth some of the most magnificent art ever produced in the history of mankind, Japanese art, Hokusai. The Japanese history is so rich, and it's being eliminated with this event called Fukushima, which is also eliminating everything else on this planet. I have to admit, I don't understand the profound significance of why. The why part eludes me. However, I do understand that it is happening, and anyone that is not talking, thinking, meditating, attempting to reverse this process, it is in all of our interest to reverse this process. And I say again, it's not a matter of information. My paintings are not information. Art is not information. It has been hijacked. It has been placed on walls in museums. And yes, we need the necessary places to place our art, our work, but do not be fooled by the nature of what it is that you're looking at, because it's not information. It is the direct and deep insight into your own soul. When the art works, it is a direct window to your own soul. It will be that which will change you on a basic, fundamental, the most primitive connection that we have to existence and survival. This is art. This is what you're looking at. You're not looking at a pretty picture. You're looking at that which will change you, the most important event in your life. And I'm saying anyone that is not directly dealing with this topic is of virtually no relevance. There are many, many, many topics that as a human race, as a society, as people living with each other, need to change, need to come to. But we have no future as long as this nuclear monster is ravaging us. And I said yesterday in my last video that I feel we are in stage two of in the age of fission. The age of fission began 70 years ago, maybe a little earlier. Madame Curie, the radiology, they all died, by the way, of cancer. They died of cancer. This was a signal to us. Nonetheless, it doesn't matter. We'll do it anyway. One of the YouTubers, Terrence Namoto, commented the fact that, and I think I talked with Blanche about this, Oppenheimer calling the general before detonating the bomb. He said it could set alight the entire atmosphere and suck all the oxygen off the planet. Well, it is now happening. Oppenheimer's fear is now happening. The ocean, the Pacific Ocean, the oxygen is being removed through nuclear radiation in the ocean, in the Pacific Ocean, which will render it totally lifeless in a very short period of time. I ask, what else? What else could be talked about? Somebody contacted me and said, methane in the Gulf. Sinkholes, methane released. Yes, methane released. Oil spills, the oil gulf. It was a horrendous oil spill, which is still continuing and devastating the coast by design, I believe by design. Another story. This by design, the nuclear devastation now occurring on our watch, all of our watch. will be another video. I'm thinking of separating this on our watch idea. It's happening on our watch. Your watch, my watch. This is happening in time, in the present, our watch. The extinction level event is occurring. Geologically speaking, a very short period of time, but for us, you and me, it is a time of most importance. It is the most important time all of us on this planet are experiencing right now, and it's the only topic worth exposing. And with the resolution in mind, we need to stop this monster Fukushima from continuing to radiate us all, because it is so difficult to comprehend, for me to comprehend this. I'm a positive person. I'm very positive. I have always been very hopeful, but it's being sucked right out of me. Like I said, I can't work. I can't work anymore because it's not just a psychological event. Oh, Ackerman, you know what? Think about something nice and think about something positive. You know, why don't you get laid? Whatever it is that you want to have, go ahead and have it. Have your cognac, have your cigars, and you'll be able to make work. No, it's not how it works. The real art happens from deep inside of us, and I'm feeling I'm unable to work because I realize now we are not making progress. Blanche told me that the reason I can't work is the same way he feels. We're not making any progress. We're not seeing any results. And I listen to other YouTubers of conscience, people of conscience that are posting, but they're not getting it. They're not getting it. Yes, they're dealing with very important issues, but there is no other issue. It's the only issue. It's the only thing that matters. We're not going to have a future, not in 50 years, but in 10 years, in 5 years. The future is over. The collapse, the economic collapse. Ha ha! Ah, what a joke, what a joke. The economic collapse, yeah, right. Or whatever else you want to, you know. Okay, fine. You know what I'll give you? It's that meteor coming in from outer space and a direct hit with a 2-3 mile wide, huge piece of chunka, and hits the earth, and it would devastate everything. All nuclear would be gone, that's for sure. Maybe that would be a solution to the planet as well. All nuclear will be gone. The most dreadful thought that one could possibly have, being hit by a huge meteor. And I'm saying it's the only thing. And it's not something we made. Those things float around out there anyway, and they come and hit us. What can you do? But we can do something about this, and nobody within, and I say nobody with conscience, because if we're 7 billion or close to 7 billion people, and there is 3, 4, 5, 10, maybe 20 people posting on a daily basis to alert us, that's nobody. And I'm not diminishing any of the posts that Blanche or anyone else is doing the way I'm doing it, but I'm saying we got to get to the next level of people realizing this is the only topic we're talking about. My thought of the day.